At BBC.com is an article entitled "The Mystery of Screaming Schoolgirls in Malaysia," dated 2019, and written by Heather Chen. "It was a quiet Friday morning," begins Heather, "last July when pandemonium broke out at a school in northeast Malaysia. Siti Nuranisa, a 17-year-old student, was at the center of the chaos. This is her account of what happened. The assembly bells rang. I was at my desk feeling sleepy when I felt a hard, sharp tap on my shoulder. I turned around to see who it was, and the room went dark. Fear overtook me. I felt a sharp, splitting pain in my back, and my head started spinning. I fell to the floor. Before I knew it, I was looking into the other world. Scenes of blood, gore, and violence. The scariest thing I saw was a face of pure evil. It was haunting me. I couldn't escape. I opened my mouth and tried to scream, but no sound came out. Then I passed out. CT's outburst triggered a powerful chain reaction that ripped through the school. Within minutes, students in other classrooms started screaming, their frantic cries ricocheting through the halls. One girl fainted after claiming to have seen the same dark figure. Classroom doors slammed shut at the Kedara National Secondary School in Kelantan as panicked teachers and students barricaded themselves in. Islamic spiritual healers were called to perform mass prayer sessions. By the end of the day, 39 people were deemed to have been affected by an outbreak of mass hysteria. Mass hysteria, or mass psychogenic illness as it's also known, is the rapid spread of physical symptoms such as hyperventilation and twitching among a substantial group of people with no plausible organic cause. American medical sociologist and author Robert Bartholomew says, "It is a collective stress response prompting an overstimulation of the nervous system. Think of it as a software problem," end quote. The mechanisms behind mass hysteria are often poorly understood, and it is not listed in the DSM, the Manual of Mental Disorders. But psychiatrists like Dr. Simon Wesley from King's College Hospital in London view it as collective behavior. He says the symptoms experienced are real: fainting, palpitations, headaches, nausea, shaking, even fits. It is often attributed to a medical condition, but for which no conventional biomedical explanation can be found," end quote. Transmission, he adds, is largely due to psychological and social factors. Outbreaks have been recorded around the world, with cases dating back as early as the Middle Ages. Incidents in Malaysia were particularly prevalent among factory workers during the 1960s. Today, it largely affects children in schools and dormitories. Robert Bartholomew spent decades researching the phenomenon in Malaysia. He calls the Southeast Asian country the mass hysteria capital of the world. Quote, "It is a deeply religious and spiritual country where many people, especially those from rural and conservative states, believe in the powers of traditional folklore and the supernatural. But the issue of hysteria remains a sensitive one. In Malaysia, cases have involved adolescent girls from the Malay Muslim ethnic majority more than any other group." Mr. Bartholomew says there's no denying that mass hysteria is an overwhelmingly female phenomenon. It's the one constant in the academic literature about mass hysteria. Surrounded by lush green rice fields, the sleepy Malay village of Padang sits on the outskirts of Kelantan's capital, Kota Baru. It's a small, tight-knit community where everyone knows each other, the sort of place that would make many Malaysians reminisce about how their country used to be. There are family-run restaurants, beauty salons, a mosque, and good neighborhood schools. CT and her family live in a modest single-story terrace house, easily distinguishable by its weathered red roof and green exterior door. An old sturdy motorbike she shares with her best friend, who lives nearby, is parked outside. CD says, "We rode it to school on the morning I was possessed by spirits." Like any other teen, stress affects CT. She says she felt it most during her final school year in 2018, the prior year to the incident, when all important examinations loomed. She says, "I was preparing for weeks, trying to memorize my notes, but something was wrong. It felt like nothing was going into my head." The incident at school during the July study period left CT unable to sleep or eat. It took her a month of rest before she returned to her almost regular self. An outbreak of mass hysteria usually begins with what experts call an index case, the first person to become affected. In this story, that is CT. And in the Dancing Plague story, there was also one person that was given the credit for starting the Dancing Plague. "It doesn't happen overnight," says Robert Bartholomew. "It starts with one child and quickly spreads to others because of an exposure to a pressure cooker environment of stress."